All right.
Did I really die on the second floor?
Yeah, you died on the second floor.
She just does so little damage.
I'm trying to think of who I should play as so that it's just, like, not confusing. We're going to play as Lazarus.
Because I need Isaac, man.
No, because I have the D6, and then that gets all confusing, and I don't want to have to deal with it. So.
You just start a new file.
I could just start a new file, but I'm not going to start a new file. So, here we have one of the Isaacs. Actually, I'm going to return to the main menu, because I'm just going to go through and explain this. So, you have a bunch of playable characters. I haven't bothered to count them. Looks like 11, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, you have 11 playable characters. All right. All of these characters start with different stats. So, Isaac is your basic starting character. He gets 3 red hearts to start with. He's got decent speed and decent attack. Those stats don't really tell you all of them right off the bat on the starting screen, but they all do have individual stats. And a lot of them start with an item, like an item to start the game with. So Isaac starts with 3 red hearts for health. His speed's just average speed, and he's got average damage. He's kind of like the baseline for everything, right? She's got 1 extra red heart. She starts with 4 red hearts. She's got slightly slower speed, as the boot says she has 1 speed. And she's got the same amount of damage. And she starts with an item that when she uses it, fills her health back up. Like, to 1 heart. Like, fills 1 heart worth of health. Kane, he starts with 2 hearts. Which is, you know, 1 less than the regular starting one. I think he is slightly faster, though it doesn't show it on here. And he also has, like, a slightly higher rate of fire or damage. I don't really remember which. But he only fires out of 1 eye, so he kind of has to have, like, the compensated increased tier rate, fire rate. And he starts with Luck Foot, which is just a luck upgrade. And luck, we'll get into stats in a little bit, I guess. Judas, he starts with 1 heart and 2 speed, so regular speed. But he only gets 1 red heart to start with, and he has a bunch of damage. He starts with 3 damage, which isn't that much, like a damage stat of like, who knows how much. But he starts with an item called the Book of Belial, which you'll see down here, which he can use to like, the attacks are tears. Yeah. So you shoot tears out of your face, and that's how you hurt enemies. So you're crying on them, and the attacks are tears. But he starts the Book of Belial, and that makes your I thought you were a genius. Man, there's so much left to learn, I know, right? Judas, you know, Book of Belial, extra damage for 1 room. And you can reuse that. It's a reusable item. This is Blue Baby. He is...
Rosie, I'm just being annoying.
Oh, yeah, no, don't worry about it. Oh, Rosie. Wait, who's Rosie? What? I don't know. Silas is saying things. Alright, Blue Baby, he starts with 3... 3 blue hearts. It was super educational. Oh my goodness. It's absurd. Blue hearts can't be regenerated like red hearts. You live like they do. They're temporary. So he only gets like 3 of them for the entire game, and you have to find more if you want more. He starts with the poop, which just makes a thing of poop on the ground. Eve is complicated, and I don't like her, so we're not going to talk about her. Samson. He's got the same amount of... He's got 3 starting health, 2 speed. He starts with slightly less damage, but he starts with an item called Bloody Lust, which gives him more damage every time he gets hit, and it lasts for the entire floor. Azazel is just broken and overpowered. He starts with flying and 3 black hearts and a laser beam that explodes everything. Lazarus is like Isaac, but he gets an extra life. Or when he dies, he comes back with 1 heart, basically. Eden starts with random items, random stats, and the Lost has no health, gets hit once, and he dies, and has regular damage and regular speed. I guess for the sake of everything, yeah, we're going to play Lazarus. What?
Yeah.
Yes?
Are you going to be streaming for a while?
Probably like 1 more run. 1 or 2 more runs, yeah. Not that okay. Much longer.
Just because I was thinking I'll probably just start getting ready for stuff. Well, I could host you if you want.
Oh, no, it doesn't matter.
If you're only going for a second, then...
I mean, it's just going to be 1 more run. It's not even going to be a big deal.
Okay.
Yeah. So, cool. And it's just going to be the...
hop off then.
Alright. It was good having you, talking with you, playing with you.
Always.
Always.
Nice to talk to you again, Genius. You the best. Look forward to, like, seeing you more. Here on Ziggy's or on mine or whatever. Whatever is the deal. And I'm getting out of here. But you're awesome. Later, bro.
Later, dog. So we're going to play as Lazarus, and I'm going to play as Lazarus because he doesn't have, like, any weird stats or anything different. Oh, yeah. He's just... He's like, as normal as they get once you're past a certain game point in the game. So that's... He starts with, like, regular stuff. It does say times one up there. When he loses all three of his red hearts, he comes back with one more red heart. And he also starts with a pill. We're not going to worry about that right now. And I just used it, but again, don't worry about it. We'll talk about it. So, we shoot tears in four directions, all the cardinal directions. We walk. You can walk at varying speeds using the control stick. Ooh! Just like a little strut. Let's see. Tears have a certain range, right? So, they only go that far. My range is not great. It is the bow and arrow icon on that picture. Not the arrows, I remind you, that's like your rate of fire. But the bow and arrow, that's your range stat. And right now, I can't quite fire from half the room, so I'm a little under... I'm probably like a third if I stayed right here. No, almost half. Almost half the room, which is not bad. Oh, tears. So they fire straight, but you can kind of angle them, right? So if you're moving and then you fire them, they keep the momentum. So you can fire them at different angles. You don't necessarily have to fire them exactly straight every time. So, that's important information. Kind of. Well, you know it is. It is important information. Let's talk about all the rooms that we come to. This is a spike trap room or a self-sacrifice room. I think it's self-sacrifice room is the canonical name. You step on the spikes. It hurts you. It doesn't look like it does much, and it usually doesn't. Most people avoid these. When you step on it, it gives you a chance to spawn a chest or a golden chest, and those can drop consumables and stuff, but for the most part, not worth stepping on these. These are bad news, so you just usually leave them alone. No problem there. So, when you beat a room, sometime a consumable drops, and you can pick up the consumable, and you keep it, and there's a little tally up here in the top left corner. You know, and the little key. I have one of those now, so that's cool. This room right here with the golden trim on it, that is the item room. There's one on every floor. On the very first floor, it doesn't cost you a key to get in, but on every subsequent floor, it costs you a key. So, we're gonna go in here. For some reason, that poop just exploded. This is an item. Ooh, you can look at it. You can try to guess what it is. Yay! This is the most exciting part about Isaac. It's going, oh man, there's an item. I don't know what it does. Let's pick it up. E. coli? Oh no, we have Turdy Touch, and now we're covered in poop. So now we're covered in poop. And there's some unknown effect to it. And this is a passive item, right? So it's constantly there. It's always being affected. You can see it in my stuff. And the effect is always in, you know, it's always there. And we'll come across, maybe if I can, I'll show you what it does. It'll probably just happen by chance. You can walk diagonally through these spikes, by the way, and not get hurt, but you have to do it really, really well, or you get take damage. Some rooms don't have a point, like that one. This is a big spider who shits out tinier spiders. That's about it. They move pretty fast. They're annoying. Sometimes they're hard to kill. Okay, so I'm going to show you what E. coli does. E. coli, it does damage on contact. Like, you damage enemies on contact. You still take damage, but it damages enemies on contact and turns them into poop. Woo! Alright, you have to kind of, like, experiment in order to figure that out, though. Like, the game doesn't outright tell you. You just kind of have to see it happen. This is a boss room, the one with the skull over the top of it. That's a boss room. Bosses that are tinted strange colors are champion bosses. They have, like, a little extra thing to their attacks, usually. This one is, sometimes he shoots a bullet out of the front of his face. Usually it's just, he wanders around the room between these rocks, and tries to attack you, but like not actively. This is a really easy boss, and I got a good one to show off. And I might die, just because I don't know. It happens sometimes. But health bar at the top. That's the boss's health. You shoot tears at the boss, and the boss loses health. It's pretty basic stuff. We could have taken some damage right there, but he didn't. Larry Jr.'s attack pattern is basically wander around the room between these rocks, poop sometimes, and then I guess Green Larry Jr. stops for a second and then shoots a bullet or a tear out of the front of his face, a bloody tear. Or I guess just blood out of the front of his face. Okay. So, try to destroy Larry Jr. He's pretty close to dead. Alright. So, you get an item for beating a boss. A lot of these times, the items you're going to pick up from beating a boss are just health upgrades. Yay! There's some other things that aren't necessarily health upgrades, and hopefully we'll see some of those. I picked up a spirit heart, okay? Spirit heart's that blue heart in the top left corner, right? It's a temporary heart container, so I technically only have 4 heart containers. And those can hold 4 red hearts, and each one, you know, every time you get hit by an enemy, you take half a heart of damage. So it's taking me like 8 hits, right? You can kind of think of the spirit hearts, or the blue hearts, as armor. So when you take them, you know, it takes that damage first, but once they're gone, they can't be refilled, right? You have to pick up more of them in order to get them back. Like a James Bond kind of armor mechanic, or like a old-style first-person shooter armor mechanic. Okay, more keys. We got tiny poops, bunch of flies, an easy room. We have no way of getting to that key because we don't have a bomb. I don't think we've had a bomb this whole run. The bombs do exist. They are consumable. Okay, we get another pill. Okay, so pills. When you first pick them up, they have a question mark, 3 question marks. We don't know what they could do. The effects can be good, they can be bad, they can like have no effect. So we're going to try it out. Bombs are key. So it made all of our bombs turned all of our keys into bombs. You'll notice that we had 2 keys. Now we have 2 bombs. Woo. So we're going to drop a bomb, blow up this rock, and get a key. So now we have 1 bomb and 1 key. Is there a reason the entire game tends to revolve around poop? The developer kind of likes poop is funny. And poop is a thing. So, yeah, that's it. There's just poop in the game. There's lots of poop. It's an especially poop-themed game. Poop and blood. It's a pretty, you know, it's family-friendly in almost every respect, as you can tell. But no, there is no particular reason the game revolves around poop so much. It's all biblically themed, so there is that theming, so if you wanted to know why that is, I have a better explanation to that, but that's, there's no reason why the poop is necessarily a huge deal. It just is. It's supposed to, you know, be partially funny, be partially gross, make it kind of dark and scary, but also kind of potty humor-ish. You know, give it that balance. This room kind of sucks. But again, this is where that being able to aim your tears comes in handy, because if I just sat here and went like this, I can't do anything about it, right? He can shoot in multiple directions, I can't. If I can change, you know, that tear takes that momentum, and we can just, like, fire it in there. Thread the needle, right? Feels good. Look at us doing all this crazy damage. We're not doing very much damage, by the way. You can kind of come back around here and do the same thing from this side. Alright, so this is a trinket. I probably won't keep this trinket, but trinkets are like passive items that you can only have one of at a time, right? So this little trinket's going to show up in the bottom left corner. You can see it down there. I'm going to get into a better room to show this off. Okay, so let me drop it first. So you can drop the trinkets. Boop, dropped it. This is what my tears fire like normally. When I pick up this trinket, ringworm, my tears fire like this. It's not particularly helpful. It's just kind of to be silly. Some items look kind of funny when you use this. it, for the most part, just makes it really hard to hit enemies. So we're going to drop the trinket. I'm probably not going to keep Ringworm. Sometimes I like to keep Ringworm. This is not one of those times. So we're not going to do that. We're going to go look for our item room, which is right here. That fire just happened to drop a heart. So blowing up fire and poop can drop consumables on occasion. Not all the time, but we're getting pretty lucky. You know, so sometimes it's worth it to blow up fire and poop. And inside we have our first active item. To be fair, I don't know what this active item does, activated item does. So, I know that it teleports you to various rooms. It's called Undefined. I think it's supposed to be mysterious in the first place, but I don't know the actual effect of it. So we're going to save it, and we're going to use it after we beat the boss and everything, so that nothing gets messed up, but... So I have two blue hearts, right? And I haven't taken any damage on this floor. Okay, here's our next boss, is Monstro. And he's also tinted a different color than he normally is. And that means he's a champion. And this one just has slightly more health and is slower. What is the point of the coins? Ah, we'll get to that. I'll show you. There is a shop in the game that you can use to spend coins to get other consumables, such as bombs or keys, pills, things like that, or you can sometimes buy items if you have enough money. So, I'll show you that in a little bit. At this point, I don't have a key to get into the shop, but when I do, I will show you. We aren't doing very much damage, but that's okay. Monstro is a really easy boss. So when you don't take damage on a floor, when you don't take red heart damage on a floor, you can take spirit heart damage, but not red heart damage on a floor, and you don't take red heart damage on a boss, you can sometimes get this door to appear after a boss fight. This door down here. So we're going to pick up this item. This is Magic Scab. It's HP and a luck up, right? So it's health. It gives us this little visual effect of us having a scab on our face. It gave us a luck up, which isn't visible, but it is visible. It's that clover leaf, but it didn't raise it enough to show it on there. So that's an alright item. So this right here, when you don't take red heart damage, which is damage from any source that does damage to your, like, red heart containers, you have a chance to get this, what's called a deal with the devil, right? When you take red heart damage on the floor and you don't take red heart damage on a boss, you still have a chance to get this deal with the devil. When you take red heart damage on both the floor, like the whole level, and on the boss, your chances with the deal to get one of these rooms after you beat the boss becomes really, really slim. Like, very, very tiny. You can get some really, really good items in Deals with the Devil. If I wanted to, and I'm not going to because I don't think this item is particularly good enough to get, you know, to buy it, basically, I'm going to leave it. But you can run into this, and it'll take one of your red heart containers, which are permanent, and permanently take it away and give you this item, right? This item is Book of Belial. It's an activated item, but we already have one, an activated item, and I don't really know what it is, and I'm more interested by that than anything else. Okay. I know it's a lot, but here we go. Black hearts, right here. You can see them thumping on the ground. They work basically the same as spirit hearts. They're the same thing as spirit hearts, but when you deplete them, or aka when you take two hits of damage and that black heart disappears, it'll do damage to everything in the room. Alright, so they're just kind of like objectively better than spirit hearts. So we're gonna try it right here. Okay. Now I get to explain secret rooms. I have this map up here, right? Secret rooms have a chance to spawn, or a chance to be generated, in any place where there are three or more surrounding rooms, right? So, adjacent rooms to it. So this room right here that I just found, that's to my left, you can kind of see which room I'm in right now. It's highlighted on the map, right? Big room highlights the big room white, small room highlights the big white room, rather small room white. The one to my left is surrounded by three rooms, right? This one, the one above it, and the one below it. And it had a chance to spawn there. So I was kind of taking a chance by placing a bomb here. And when you place a bomb next to a wall that is next to a secret room. It'll blow open the wall, and you'll get this little Zelda noise, and you found the secret room. In the secret room, sometimes you can find items, like we just did. Sometimes you can find consumables, sometimes you don't find anything that interesting in them. They're kind of hit or miss, but this time we found an item, and this item is called Lost Contact. It's a Shielded Tears, and I'll show you the effect of that on the next floor when there are actually enemies. We're gonna blow another hole in this wall so I can show you how you use money. Here it is. Alright. This is the shop. It's signified on your map by a tiny little coin. That's a little cent sign. There's usually a door with a lock on it, kind of like an item room, and in order to get, you know, into this room, you would need a key. I didn't have a key, so I wasn't going to be able to enter it, and I wasn't going to be able to show you how to buy items. I can't really show you how to buy items right now. I can. Never mind. I totally can. I have 7 cents. So, I have 7 cents. I want to buy something that's 15 cents. Oh, wait, you can't. It just doesn't work. You would normally just walk into it, and you would take it, and it would take your 15 or your money. But I don't have 15 cents, I have 7. So I'm going to just buy this spirit heart right here. It just involves me running into it. I now have 2 cents instead of 7 cents. And that's how the shop works. There's one on every floor up to a certain point. And they always take one key to get into. Unless you can bomb your way into it through a secret room like we just did. Alright. So we're done with this floor. We've cleared everything. There's still one more room, and we're going to go check that out because it's an important room. And it's this room with a little half-crescent red moon and a star. And this is the self-sacrifice room. Or not the self-sacrifice room, the curse room. Right? So curse room, you take damage walking into it. Just a half a heart, you can see up here. And there's sometimes stuff inside of it, like 2 red chests. And you take half a heart leaving it. So we're going to see what's inside of our red chests. We got a bomb. It's called a troll bomb. They just follow you and they try to explode. And we got an item. Now, I know what this item does. This is not a good item for me right now. And I don't know, I'm not too dedicated to winning the run, so I guess I'll pick it up. But normally you'd be like, oh my goodness, I found an item. This is awesome. And then you pick it up. Dead cat, 9 lives, that's sweet. But did you notice what happened to my red hearts? Oh shit, I had like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 red hearts, and now I only have 1. It didn't take away my spirit hearts, which is cool. Now I have only 1 red heart. That's really shitty. That's not what I want. And I gave me... Now I have 10 lives, right? I had the one that I started out with. Extra one that I started out with because I started as Lazarus. But I got another 9 because I picked up the dead cat. Which is this little... And you can... It's signified by this like little floating cat familiar thing. So he's going to follow me around. But yeah, now I have 10 lives, but each one only respawns me with 1 red heart. Which can be good and can be bad. Alright, so the only thing we haven't done, we've explored this entire floor, is use our active item. And this is, it's signified in the top left corner. So using the active item, or spacebar item, when you're playing on the keyboard, is you just hit the spacebar. This one teleports us to, I think, a special room. So it teleported us to the item room. Woo! Didn't do a whole lot for us here because we've already seen every room on the floor. Not a particularly great item, but, maybe sometimes can bring us to places that normally we wouldn't be able to get to. So, that's not terrible. We're going to go down to the next floor. So, trapdoor leads us down to the next floor. Alright. We have a little vignette of all the terrible things that have happened to us in our lives. Like, our best, 2 kids at school, pooping on us. Alright. What else? So, we have what is called a mob trap room. So what happens in here is that you'll pick up whatever's in here, and then it'll spawn 3 waves of enemies, and you have to fight those 3 waves of enemies, and then you can leave. I can't open this chest. I don't have a key. Golden chests, you need a key to open. I can't open it. I can just push it around for a little bit. Not that that's necessarily really helpful, but I can do that. And we're just going to keep moving on. So, I still can't show you Shielded Tears effect, but that's okay. We picked up a penny, there's a key behind there, and a bomb behind there, but I don't have a bomb to blow up these rocks, so I can't get to them. We're stuck here. Alright, so this is where you're first going to see Shielded Tears. Shielded Tears can block other enemies' tears, right? We can block other people's shots with our own shots, which is really cool. And can be really, really helpful for a lot of the late game bosses if you can get the high enough, you know, fire rate to kind of compensate. Important to note about Shielded Tears, though, is that when your tears hit their tears, it also stops yours. So if you're not firing faster than the enemy, you're not going to be able to hit them, right? So these guys have a lot of health. A lot of health. There we go. One down. Okay, blow him up. He kind of turns into like little giblets there. Pieces of bacon probably on the floor. And I want to show you a little cool ambient thing about this game that you don't really notice all the time, but you'll notice sometimes. There's a little tiny, like, little worm maggot walking around on the ground, and you can see him right here. I'm going to circle him a few times. He's just chilling, minding his own business, but you can step on him. It splats and turns into a blood splat, because you're a terrible person. What else? Alright, so we got some enemies. Purple tears means homing tears. Means that these things are going to follow us. The shots are going to follow us, which is kind of not good for us. We don't have a good enough range to be able to, you know, stay at a distance. Yeah, I know. It's delicious. Little bacon giblets. Oh! Keep dodging those tears. As much as they are homing, they do have a distance to them, right? So eventually they'll hit the ground, and if we can dodge them until they hit the ground, we can't be hurt. So, we finally have a key. So we can actually go into one of these rooms. So, most lock rooms that you see that aren't the item room are going to be the shop. This isn't always the case. I might be able to show you one of these other locked rooms, but for the most part, it's going to be the shop. Item room's obviously the item room because it's got the big golden, you know, door on it. And I think for the most part are the generally widely accepted as the better room to, like, the room you want to focus getting to, right? This is the most important one because it's going to make your run interesting and cool and good. This is not a good item. This is a bad item. We're going to pick it up. It's Mr. Boom. It's a bomb. You drop it, it explodes, that's it. But what I can use it for is I can come back here, and I was like, man, I really wanted this key. I don't have another key, so we're going to drop Mr. Boom. Boom. We got a key for free, basically. It costs us a key to get the item, but that's beside the point. Up here, by the top left corner, you can see by Mr. Boom that there's these two bars, right? There's it's like this bar next to it that's separated into two bars. When you beat a room, we'll pick that up in a second. When you beat a room, we need more damage, man. It's not a very good run, but it's a run nonetheless. When you beat a room, it fills up partway with green. It fills up one of those bars with green. Depending on what item you have, it'll have more or less charges that it needs to be filled. So every room you fight gives you one charge on an item. After two charges with Mr. Boom, you can use it again. This is a mini-boss. Not an actual boss, but a mini-boss. And this one is Super Pride, and it's actually the creator of the game, Edmund McMillan, who's the big green guy, and Florian, who is a programmer on the first game, and who's the tiny little floating baby thing. And we don't have very much damage, so this boss might take a little bit. But the bosses usually come and are known as the Seven Deadly Sins, and I hope you know what the Seven Deadly Sins are. You have like Sloth, Pride, Gluttony, Greed, lust, and envy, right? I think that's right. And this is Super Pride, right? He's not just regular Pride, but Super Pride, which is kind of just like a joke on himself, is that he thinks he's so good that he put himself in as Super Pride. It's totally not even a thing. He seems like a really not prideful person, very humble. Do we want the left hand? We don't really want the left hand. I'm not going to deal with some weird trinkets that I don't feel like I really need right now. So, charged again, so we're gonna use it. Blow up some rocks. Pick up a bomb. Now we're gonna just go return Mr. Boom to his spot. We are gonna take the other item instead. Undefined. So, we have undefined. Okay, so we have a room that takes a key here, and we have a room that takes a key here. One of these is most likely the shop, and the other one is some other secret room, special room. If we can get another key, I'm willing to try to open both of them so I can show you what that is, what that other room is. If we can't, then we can't, and we'll just skip it for now. Right, so Shield of Tears are great because we're stopping his shots, right? But he's firing like almost as fast as we are, so we can't hit him with our own shots. It's kind of a pain. This is a tarot card. It works a lot like a pill, but you can know what it does when you first pick it up. You're not taking any chances. It exists as what it is, right? Nothing more, nothing less, nothing too hard to deal with. Two of Clubs is it multiplies one of your consumables. There's a Two of Diamonds, a Two of Hearts, and a Two of Spades as well. Two of Spades multiplies your keys by two, which right now would just give us two keys, because we have one. One times two is two. Two of Clubs is bombs. If we used it right now, it would just give us two. We would just be at two bombs instead of one bombs. So this item gets way better the more bombs you have, because if you had like four bombs and you used it, then you would be getting eight bombs total, which is, that's not bad. That's actually pretty good. Oh, I forgot we have Turdy Touch. That's pretty sweet. So this is Gold Poop. Gold Poop, when you break it, it's full of money. Like, real gold poop, I guess. And now our shop is worth going to, and I'll show you why. So we're going to fight Peep. Peep is a decently difficult boss. Not in the first stages of his boss fight, I remind you. Because, all he's going to do is pee a little bit on the ground, which hurts us if we step on it. And he's going to jump around. And I just stepped on the pee, so I guess, fuck me. Like, I don't know what I'm talking about. But this boss fight gets substantially more difficult once you get a third of his health gone, right? Once he loses a third of his health, one of his eyes pops out and starts floating around the room, which you're like, oh, that's not that difficult. You just gotta avoid the eye and still shoot the boss. And you can't hurt the eyeball. And you're like, that's not that bad. But can you guess what happens when you get to two-thirds of his health gone? Oh, we'll see. That's the real surprise. And look at me, still taking damage. Oh, we have two clubs. I forgot. So if I wanted, I could use two clubs right now. If you look at our bomb count, we have three bombs. If I use it, boom, we have six bombs. That's a lot of bombs. So many bombs, in fact, that I'm willing to go like this and blow up that rock. And that rock was a tinted rock. Shit, what does a tinted rock mean? It was slightly different color than the other rocks, and so it has a chance to drop items. What? So that's what we did. I know that was pretty fast, and I couldn't explain it better, but sometimes it drops health, and I was really hoping that it would drop health. I'm gonna die right here. Alright. So, Lazarus comes back to life with one heart when he dies. So that's one of our lives right now. We're using it. We're using the Lazarus life. When Lazarus gets hit after he's died, he starts to bleed everywhere. So we have this new item, and it's called anemia, basically, that dying as Lazarus gives us. And when we get hit, we just constantly bleed and we don't stop. And, and it hurts enemies when they step on it. We're going to pick up the pin here, the safety pin, evil and range shot speed up. So he gave us a range upgrade, so we're shooting, significantly farther across the room. We're no longer shooting only halfway across the room, but we're shooting, majority of the room. And then we also, our tears are firing, are flying a little bit further, a little bit faster, because that's due to the shot speed upgrade. Not, like, rate of fire upgrade, but, like, shot speed. Like the rate at which the tears fly across the room upgrade. And then an evil up gave us the black heart. So we're going to check one of these rooms, and it was the shop. All right. So inside the shop, we have a bunch of items, none of which are very helpful for us right now. So we're going to use our activated item. Woo! And it took us to the I Am Air room, which is what I wanted to show you. This is a really rare room that a lot of people do not see all that often. And, you know, is, as I said, just really rare. Not much more to say about it. And we had an item. This is Guppy's head. Looks a lot like, you know, the dead cat, which it is. But it allows us to spawn some flies every room, which I don't think is better than Undefined. But this room right here, and I apologize, epilepsy warning, a little late, but epilepsy warning nonetheless. I don't know if I can blow this guy up. I can. I Am Error Room happens. Sometimes there are different with like rooms that can teleport you places, and there's a very, 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 very tiny chance that it will teleport you to this room, which has a bunch of like random consumables and potentially an item and really crazy effects, and it's really hard to find. It doesn't happen very often, so we got lucky. We're playing as Lazarus. So, we're taking Undefined with us. We have Trickle Charge. That's our little consumable, or our trinket down there in the bottom left. Trickle Charge just makes it so that we charge our item faster, our usable item faster, which wouldn't have been any help to us if we kept Guppy's head, because Guppy's head is a one room recharge. You use it, and then when you beat the room, you can use it again. You know, it has no effect on it. So that's not something that we would want. I stepped on that. That's not good. I don't know why I'm keeping this half heart interval, but we're just leaving blood everywhere. These guys can only be hurt when they pop up. Come on, pop up. Yeah, there we go. And we're gonna pick up the other half of this red heart. Okay, we have another special room. Woo, the arcade. It's another place you can go to spend money. You can spend money to play the slot machine, which occasionally pays out with things, like a pill. The pill being explosive diarrhea, so we shit bombs, basically. This is the blood bank. You hit it. It takes one of your half a red heart and gives you money in return. You can, you know, do this as much as you want. I kind of am fond of my health right now, so we're not going to do that. This is a three skull Monty, very much like the slot machine over here. You play him, it gives you a chance to get a consumable. Boom. It's a 1/3 chance. We got two keys. It's pretty sweet. Might as well play this one more time. No point. We're gonna keep going. These are two-headed worm maggots. I call them cat dog worms. Cat dog maggots. Whatever, which one you want to use, that's fine. You don't have to use either. You can make up your own name. It could be Greg or Steve or Nathaniel. It doesn't really matter. Wall spiders, not a huge deal. Especially when we're firing, you know, tears that stop other bullets. So, and as I say that, I still take damage again. I just took a bunch of damage on that room than I should have. Alright, another item. This is Leo, right? Yeah, Leo, Stompy. It's a zodiac symbol. We're really big. It allows us to just walk through rocks. Any rocks that I can walk through any of these previous rooms? Yeah. We don't need bombs to blow up rocks anymore, son. We can just walk right through them. What? It's pretty sweet. Blowing up rocks. Another blood bank that just spawned in the middle of a room. We've got a bomb, which we're going to use to blow up the blood bank. And inside was a spirit heart and a penny. Those are variable drops. It can be any number of different consumables that drop out of those. But sometimes it is worth it to blow it up, because I was low on health and didn't want to die again. So. There I go, taking more damage. We've got a lot of keys. We've got a pretty decent number of keys. Much more than we had when we started. Or at the earlier stages of this run. So, that item is charged again. Let's use it. And it took us to the secret room, or the second secret room, where there is a fortune teller, which works a lot like the slot machine, but when you pay money, it has a chance to tell you a fortune, or sometimes it'll drop a spirit heart. We're not going to bother with it, we're going to blow it up, and it dropped a trinket, and that trinket is the Ace of Spades. Play if you want to know what the Ace of Spades does. I don't want to ruin every surprise, you know. If you, like, think you might enjoy this game, you know, go pick it up. It's fairly cheap. It's like $15 or something. And it, you know, it's... There's so much shit in this game that it takes you hours upon hours to, like, find and see everything that this game has to offer, which is great. I mean, I think I have 100 hours put into this one and maybe 500 hours put into the first one. And this game's been out for a month, and I've had 100 hours on it, so... I was at 100 hours, like, within the first 2 weeks. I just haven't played it a whole hell of a lot recently, because I'm busy with school and such, but... College is hard, man. Literally so much shit. Yeah, I know. There's literally so much shit in this game, it's worth... So I died. But we had 9 lives, so we spawned outside the room with all of our health, or with 1 heart. This is the kind of shitty part about 9 lives, is that, you know, once you start dying, it just kind of doesn't stop. That's an item I don't really care for. That's spirit heart. We're gonna take the spirit heart, and we're gonna try to do this. We're gonna try to beat this boss. Literally so much shit. The crazy thing about how much shit there is in this game is that, yeah, it's both literally and figurative shit, but I guess they're both literal shit, is that you can just never see all of it. In terms of the poop, you can't see all of it, but in terms of the items, you could, and you probably can, but there are so many combinations of items and things that work together with each other, it's called, what us in the Isaac community call synergies. That it's unlikely that you'll see all of them. Shitception. Yeah, there's the shit within shit. Shit upon shit within shit. You know, all up and all over and all around covered in it. But, yeah, it's definitely worth the $15 if you think it looks like something that's up your alley. With Shield of Tears, this boss fight, I realize, is not as hard as I thought it was. I was trying to dodge those bullets. I can just stand here and stop them before they even come out. So, this boss fight became a lot easier once I figured that out. So, I don't know if it'll count me not taking red heart damage on that boss because I didn't when I beat him. No. Okay, it didn't. So, coin purse. I dropped a bunch of pills. These pills are health upgrades. Wow. That is lucky. Speed upgrades. So we essentially just got 2 health upgrades and 2 speed upgrades from that one boss fight, which is really, really helpful. We were pretty low on health, and I wasn't too confident about our ability to continue on, at least not at the pace that we were on. So let's play this once, get a penny out of it. Sweet. Let's blow it up and get half a heart and 4 pennies out of it. And then we'll just keep... Whoa, almost stepped on that. There's a lot of money over there that I can't reach. Again, I think Shield of Tears is really a pretty good item, but I don't think that... Without attack speed, or without, fire rate ups, we're not... doing as much damage because we're not hitting the enemies as much because they're stopping the bullets with their own bullets. Really good defensive item, not so good offensive item. Okay, don't like this room so much. It doesn't mean we're gonna die to it. Die to it. These guys have a pretty decent amount of health. They just kind of charge you kind of quickly, but we have so many speed upgrades that it shouldn't be too hard to get out of the way. I think we've gotten some really interesting items. I don't think we've gotten very good items. And by that I mean our tiers are basically doing the same damage they were when we started the game, which is not the position you want to be in at this point, being on the fourth floor of the game, Caves 2. Not awful. We still have chances to make up for it, but they're not great. I need to keep playing you a little bit. There's a few item unlocks that I still don't have, and one of them is you get from playing this guy, I think, a total of 100 times in, you know, overall. 100. Great. Just turned him into poop. Alright, nothing there. I'm the biggest doofus that's ever lived. Alright, so those two health upgrades we have, they don't mean anything anymore. We're back to one heart. Alright, Gluttony. Why didn't I know you were here earlier? That would have made me so happy. Gluttony is one of the sins, you know, another mini-boss. We fought Pride on the last floor, we're fighting Gluttony on this floor. There isn't a mini-boss on every floor, it's just randomly generated, so every time is different. We're gonna pick this up, we're gonna teleport to the regular secret room. And I just accidentally gave that man a key. Paralysis, he can't move for a second. So we're gonna give him a few more keys. Gave us a red chest, inside of which was a bomb. We're gonna make that bomb blow him up, because what a dick. This is an extra large room full of, like, torsos of fat guys. Fatty torsos. Could be worse, could be better. Definitely not too scared of this room. Oh, different tinted color enemies, like different tinted color bosses, are slightly stronger and have different little effects to them. So the dark tinted ones explode like a bomb and tend to drop bombs. The red tinted ones, I think, just have more health and maybe explode into red bullets, or maybe just turn into like a secondary ooze state. We'll see. I don't remember. They drop hearts, though. Yeah. And a boss trap room. So, boss trap room is a lot like that mob trap room we saw earlier. But when you activate the things inside of it, you have to fight three bosses instead. We're not going to do that. We're going to use this moon card and teleport the fuck out. And keep moving on. Ow. If you were wondering why I wasn't stepping all those mushrooms, that's why. Sometimes they explode into a poisonous gas cloud. That hurts. And then you take damage and you cry to your mom. Whew. We're moving along pretty quickly here. Got 7 lives left. I should have died right there, probably. But I didn't. I'm going to die on this floor, though, on this room anyway. Let's not go that way. I don't like that room. This room is full of keys and chests. I don't want to use both my keys right there. Okay. We just got some worms, nothing too serious. Some diglets. I forgot that we can step through rocks. There's a chest inside that rock somewhere. 2 diamonds. Doubles our coins. We have 18, now we have 36. Got a lot of money. It makes the shop worthwhile now. We're gonna open this golden chest. And inside the golden chest is infamy. Infamy. It's damage reduction. So this item gives us a chance not to take damage when we get hit by a bullet. Yay. Kind of helpful. Not the most helpful. Not the best item. Because it only happens on occasion. But, you know, occasional damage prevention is better than no damage prevention. So it's good to have. And, you know, as you play and you get all these items, Isaac looks less and less like what he did when he started, but he's got a room full of spikes. Larry Jr., which, as you notice, was a first floor boss, is now just a regular enemy. Does have a boss health bar, so I guess he would be considered a like mini boss or something at this point. Is now, you know, it's just a common enemy. We're gonna go in that room, but after we have a charge on our item here, because then we can teleport out and not get killed. So these are not high level, but you know, medium low level strategies that you can use to maybe survive a little bit longer or get something good that you wouldn't have normally been able to get, you know, due to lack of health and stuff like that. Which we're not, you know, we're not doing so great on health or damage or tears, which are like the three big things that you want to do, be able to have right now. Tears being, you know, your rate of fire. The tier stat, higher tier stat means a higher rate of fire. You're firing more tears per second. You know. Not to be confused with shot speed, which is how fast your shots move across the room. So we're gonna pick that up. This room's full of... Oh, yeah! I was like, oh, gotta use bombs to get through here. But I have Leo, so this Bomberman puzzle that was initially gonna be pretty difficult. Not actually, but it's gonna take some time. I can just walk through. Okay! I'm gonna go through Tinted Rocks number 101 one more time. This rock right here has a tiny little X on it. X marks the spot. When you walk over this rock, or break it, it's going to drop a spirit heart, usually. But sometimes it can drop other consumables, or an item. So, yay, we got that. We're going to go in here. In here we find another spirit heart, which we're going to buy. And we find BFF. BFF's pretty good. We're going to buy BFF. We don't have anything with us that'll do a whole lot to it right now, but maybe later. It just makes your familiars larger and do more damage. It made Guppy's head, or Guppy's, or Nine Lives familiar bigger, but that doesn't do anything. Converter. Converter's cool because it takes two of your spirit hearts, right, the temporary hearts that we have, and turns them into one red heart. Now we only have one spirit heart, so we can't do it again, but if we do get another one, we know where to come back to. Okay, it's a pretty simple enemy. Just gonna shoot him full of, we're doing, like, no damage, by the way. This is a pretty low damage run so far. Okay. We got lucky there. That was... I probably should have taken damage. I didn't, though, so that's cool. I was about to use a bomb. We can just walk through it. Alright, it's 21 cents. Floor is this. Depths 1. So we're gonna go in. We're gonna fight this boss. It's the cage. He's just got a lot of health. I use the strength card. Strength card gives us another red heart for the room. Another red heart container for the room. It also gives us slightly increased damage. Just makes us a little bulkier, a little more damage dealing. Which is good against a boss like the cage, who can take a lot of hits before we kill him. And, you know, he's not doing his heart attacks right now. Like, his difficult to dodge attacks, he's doing his pretty easy ones. But trust me, he has some annoying attacks, and this is not one of them. Getting lucky on that front. He's just doing all of his roly-poly shit, which is not difficult at all to dodge. I mean, it's a little difficult, but we have enough speed that it's not a big deal. That, there we go. There's another one of his attacks. Jumps, comes down, does like this snaking rock-shattering effect. Get out of here, poop demon. Alright. Sweet. HP upgrade. Okay, so we saw deals with the devil earlier. Now we get to see deals with the angel. Deals with the angel are what happens when you don't take deals with the devil and then don't take damage on another floor. It's a weird system, but it's pretty good. Alright, this is the wafer. This may be exactly what we need to continue this run going. You can't blow up blue fire with your tears. You can blow it up with bombs. We're going to take the wafer. It's damage resistance. So, there are things in this game that take one heart of damage when you run into them. They do one heart of damage to you. And, you know, that sucks. One heart of damage, that's a lot. That's twice as much as you normally do. And past a certain point, everything does that. There's about two more floors, and then everything is going to start dealing one whole heart of damage to us. With the wafer, those things will only be dealing half heart of damage, so we'll basically have twice as much health as we do right now on those later floors. Or at least than we normally would. It's the same amount of health as we do right now, but... Besides the point, Wafer's really good. That's basically all I'm telling you, is it's good. This is a very defensive run, where we're not doing a whole lot of damage, but we have a lot of stuff to help us from dying. And that's, you know, multiple lives, Infamy, the Wafer, you know. But that doesn't really help you if you can't avoid taking damage or kill enemies fast enough to keep you from taking damage, so... This is not my favorite kind of run. In fact, this is probably my least favorite kind of run, where we are, you know, more defensively oriented than we are offensively oriented. But it means I have to play a little bit better to survive, because I have to, you know, get more hits in without getting hit, basically. Sure, we have a little bit of lenience, because we can take hits, but, you know, we don't want to. These enemies have, like, brains on the backs of their heads, so... And these, like, stone-looking masks on the front, you want to hit them in the back of the head. Or, you know, if you can sneak in a shot from the side, do that too. Whew. Range downgrade. So, still got pretty good range. It was very minimal. We're gonna start playing this guy. He works... You give him money, he can sometimes give you stuff. He's a lot like the gambling machines in the other areas, but he has a chance to give you... Oh, get out of there! Fuck. He also has a chance to blow himself up. That doesn't happen all that often, but it does happen sometimes. So, you notice that we don't have any keys. What are we going to do? Well, we have 8 bombs. So what I'm going to do is probably use this bombs key pill and turn those 8 bombs into 8 keys and then use... the keys to enter up. Oh, yeah, we're still gonna do it. Use the key to enter this room. Wow. Okay, so we got Dead Bird. So Dead Bird only activates when you get hit. It's not that great. It took away our lion, sweet ass lion man. So in, you know, overall I'm pretty upset about this turn of events. Not terribly upset, but upset enough to you know, to warrant me talking about it basically. Keep going. Just open that up. Eh, not great. Fires and such. Okay, we're gonna use this item. Took us to the Iron Mirror room again. That's really lucky. Cool. So, I don't know what this shit is on the walls, but whatever. Butt bombs, right? Okay, so this gives us bombs that are poops, look like that. And they explode, they cloud the screen, and they confuse enemies. It's kind of like a gas bomb or something. This, whoa, some weird effects going on over here. This right here is an Eternal Heart. It goes kind of combination with our Red Heart right there. But it goes underneath the Spirit Heart. So when we take damage, it'll go through the Spirit Hearts before it'll go to this white Red Heart. If this white Red Heart gets hit, the white part disappears and you don't get it. If you can get an Eternal Heart, or that little white piece, all the way to the end of the floor and go down to the next floor... it gives you a free heart container. So it's kind of like a heart container that you get if you can make it to the next floor with it. Alright. Okay. That was a double key room. Inside the double key room was this room with the chest in the middle. Just had a bunch of bombs and stuff. And I'm not going to get the bombs that are across keys or across those spikes because that's going to be a pain in the ass. We're substantially tankier than we were. We've got another health. You know. We have some okay stuff, but we don't have any damage, and I think that's the biggest thing about this run that's going to be probably our downfall, is that we just don't have any really good methods of dealing any damage. Which is unfortunate. It's going to make the boss fights a little arduous. It's going to take a long time to get through this run. I mean, this run is taking a little bit longer because I'm kind of stopping and explaining everything. And, you know, than it normally would when I just kind of go through and play it as... you know, as if the people watching kind of already have, a pretty deep understanding of what's going on. But again, that's kind of the point of this run, is just to show people, I guess, genius what's going on. But if I upload this to YouTube, just kind of like as a starter Isaac thing, right? Like, people, what are the basics of Isaac? What's going on when I look at this game? What's happening? Because it's kind of, there's a lot of stuff. It's kind of can be overwhelming. This card is the Death card. Death card, like the Black Heart. Does damage to every enemy in the room. essentially killing weak enemies. Okay. This is like those turrets, but they walk. Those heads right there, you can't do damage to. You have to kill all the other enemies in the room first. They're kind of like a trap or something. Just to make rooms harder. Oh. Okay, we got this nickel. We do have a charge on our undefined item. See, we just stopped some damage with infamy. We turned blue for a second. That bullet that hit us didn't actually hit us and do damage. Or it did hit us, but it didn't do damage. And I know Genius might not still be here, but if he is, just letting you know. So, Aquarius. Whoa. Aquarius is good. It just leaves creep, right? So, enemies who touch this that we're leaving behind does damage. So, my computer's being weird. 1 second, guys. One moment. Oh, he's still here. Well, hello. I'm glad you're still here. If you weren't here, I'd still probably finish this run out and still keep explaining things like I am, just because I do think it's, you know, people who don't know anything about Isaac. This is hopefully an alright explanation, although it is a lot of information to take in. Aquarius, we just do, whenever enemies step on this, like, trail of tears that we're leaving, it does damage. It's nice passive damage, but again, our tears aren't doing that much damage, which is the hard part to deal with. Because we were Lazarus and we had that anemia, right, like I was talking about earlier, when we take damage on a floor or on a room, we start to leave this trail of blood everywhere. That does stack with our trail of tears to do, like, double damage, basically, on that creep that we're laying down. A creep is just the name of that, the stuff that lays on the ground and does damage when you step on it, essentially. Cool. Nothing in this room, other than that. I mean, I don't hold out a lot of hope that we're gonna win this run, but I think for the purposes that I'm doing it, it's a good explanation. So we've got decent amount of consumables, we got these fatties who are just gonna jump around and leave creep everywhere and in general be a pain in my dick, but that's okay. Nothing wrong with that. Get rid of them fairly quickly. We do have that charge on that item, but I don't really want to use it because this is an important floor, and if we get teleported to that I Am Error room, there's no way to leave it, right? So we just have to go to the next floor, and this is an important floor for a few reasons, so we kind of want to finish it out. If things get too dire, maybe we won't, but for the most part, should be okay. I'm not doing very good, taking a lot of damage. I play a lot of this game, doesn't mean I'm good at it. We haven't been given a lot in terms of, like, health or damage or anything like that, so I say we're doing alright. I think that the 9 lives pick up early on in the game, I keep taking damage from those guys, was a bad thing to do. But I kind of wanted to show it for the sake of just letting people know that, you know, not every item is going to be good. Not every item in this game is good in all situations. There are items that do better in other situations. A card against humanity. This card is hilarious. It's not a good card, but it's hilarious. I'll show you what it does. It's actually alright if you have flying, but I don't know if you know what Cards Against Humanity is. It's a card game for people with mature senses of humor. By that I mean who can speak with potty language and about racism and stuff and laugh at it without getting heated over whether or not it's right or wrong. So I'll just use it in this room. Fills the whole room with poop. It's okay, we have Leo. We can just run through everything. Normally that'd be a pain in the ass. Fills the whole room with poop. How cool is that? We got a lot of money out of it. And some hearts. Let's go in our item room. Inside of that item room, we got Mom's Key. Mom's Key's good. We got the battery, which let us overcharge our item, and then we don't have enough money for that. So we're just going to pay our 1 cent to the donation machine and keep going. Mom's key, like I said, alright, I didn't talk about Mom's key at all. Just kidding. Mom's key, we're going to check for secret room. Gives us a better chance of, I think, getting golden keys, which are keys that last for a floor, and they open all item, like, all key-related doors and chests and stuff. So, they're really good, and it gives us an increased chance of finding those, so. We're going to go through here and fight the boss. Woo! And this boss is the main boss, because this is the end boss for when you first start the game. When you first play the game, when you open it up from the package, or when you buy it on Steam and you play it for the first time, this boss is the end boss. End of the game, right here. And you would technically beat the game if you beat this boss. Cool. Sweet. There's more. There's a lot more. This is just the first ending, basically. You beat this boss enough times, then you get to move on to the farther floors, and those further, like, more distant floors are even harder than the floors before it. And, there's more bosses, and then there's a couple more endings, so there's actually 4 more levels after this fight, like 4 more floors after this fight, which means there are 4 more boss fights after this fight, and for each of those floors there's multiple bosses that you can fight, so this is not in any way the hardest, we're gonna use the strength card, in any way this hardest fight we could be doing right now, but you know, this is definitely a landmark part of the run, which is what you call anytime you start. It's not necessarily what you have to call it, but anytime you play Isaac, and you know, from life to death, what it is. And okay, Isaac is a roguelike. I don't know how I've mentioned this. Roguelikes are kind of okay. Rogue is the very very first rogue game is a kind of like an RPG, right, where there's stats. And you play through it, and you get your character gets stronger, and you have like an objective, and you usually go down multiple floors, and it's procedurally generated, which means it's every time you play it, it's different, right? Oh my god! Okay. Before we get to this, it's procedurally generated, and you know that means it's different every time you play it. But when you die, you start from the beginning, right? And it procedurally generates a second time. And then, you know, that goes on infinitum. You can get different things every time and different item different combinations. A roguelike basically just means it has random generation. It has, usually has floors, but random generation and permadeath. Permadeath means when you die, that is over. The progress for that run is gone. Some things carry over in this game, but for the most part, when you lose a run, you start back from scratch and you don't have anything. Okay. There's a bunch of things that just happened. We went to the I Am Error room, and I'm sorry, seizure warning for anybody who is susceptible to that kind of thing. We had a golden key and a regular key. I picked up the golden key. You can see next to my keys, right here. Instead of a regular key, it's a golden key. It means we can open up things that take keys, like these chests, and it won't cost us any keys. That's crazy. This only lasts for one floor, and then you have to go back to reusing your keys again, unless you pick up another golden key. Secondly, we have an item in the middle. Whoa! And this looks a lot like a worm or something, but it's actually a cat tail, the tail of a cat. So remember, we picked up 9 lives on the very, very first floor, and that gave us 1 heart, and we've had to deal with this shit the entire time, where when we die, we come back, and we have only 1 heart. We somehow got back up to 5. And then at a later point, we picked up Guppy's head, right? Which looks a lot like this, the thing that's following us, but you could use it as an activated item, and it spawned flies. Okay, so who cares? So that's, you know, 2 guppy items. This is Guppy's tail. This is another guppy item. Wow, Guppy is really popular in this game. You pick up 3 guppy items in 1 run. You don't have to have them on you. I don't have Guppy's head with me anymore, but I picked it up at some point. You pick up 3 guppy items on 1 run, you become Guppy. You can't see it because I'm wearing a mask, but I have a cute little cat face, and I can fly now. What? I can fly. There's more to this other than that, but I'll show that to you on another floor. But no, now we can fly. That's pretty sweet. That's a great upgrade. We picked up that golden key, so we're going to open all these golden chests because it's not going to cost us anything. Because we picked up the golden key. Right? Sweet. 1, 2, 3. Wow. 4. 5. 6. Jesus. Alright, let's pick up everything on this room. Oh! Oh! Feels so good. Mmm. I love it. Alright. So, Abel, this item right over here. It's kind of shitty. It's not that great. Whoa. But we have BFF, so he's big, and he does a little bit more damage than he normally does. Cool, whatever. That's Abel. He just stands on the opposite side of the room as you, and fires when you fire. This is Cricket's Head. This is what I'm more excited about. It's just a damage upgrade. We haven't had one of those yet. Damage upgrades are great. It also makes our tears bigger, which is sweet. It took away our ears, though, which makes me a little sad. Like our little guppy ears, but that's okay. We're gonna go down to the next floor. We're guppy now. We're flying. We picked up a damage upgrade. We beat Mom. We're on to the next part of the game. And now we can kind of see what the next little bit, the other big part, and this is probably the biggest part of becoming guppy, is that every time you hit an enemy, you spawn one of these little blue flies, right? And the little blue fly comes in and homes in on your enemy and hits them and does damage. Now these little blue flies do twice as much damage as your regular tears. Twice as much. So every time we hit an enemy, we spawn a fly. That fly homes in on the enemy, does twice as much damage as one of our tears. We just effectively tripled our damage output from becoming guppy. That is really good. And we can fly. I don't have to say that a bunch more, but like, we can fly. We don't have to worry about rocks. We had Stompy, so we just fly over rocks. We don't have to worry about spikes. We can just fly over the spikes. We don't have to worry about enemies who lay down damaging creep. We can just fly over it. That's awesome. We have triple damage output. That's crazy. We're going to pick this up. We're going to fight the bosses. I don't even need that item, but we're going to pick it up. No, we're not going to pick it up. I kind of like our faster charge. You see how fast we're killing things now? That's crazy. We were not killing things fast at all a second ago. Look how much damage those flies do. That's great. It's lovely. Guppy is a really good way to get damage done. It means you have to pick up guppy items, which means a lot of the times you have to go find unorthodox things. But that's a cool little transformation that there are, I think, maybe two or three in this game, two, that he wants to add more to in upcoming expansions. But, man, we've gotten some sweet as hell golden chests. We're just rolling in the dough. Okay, so yeah, this floor is normally harder. There's also this really weird filter on this floor. I'm sorry. I'm used to it by now. A lot of people aren't, but yeah, there's this red filter over the top of this. I'm feeling a lot better about this run. That's really, really good stuff. Spikes, we don't have to worry about them. We can just fly right over them. I just ran into that enemy because I wasn't paying attention, but I wanted you to be as excited about this as I am. Look at us, we're just flying over this. What? No damage. Crazy shit. Oh, right. Okay, so this is the utero. This is after the final boss. Whoa, after the final boss? That's because it's not really the final boss. It's like a fake final boss. It's a fake out. There's more after it. There's more to do, right? There's more to see, more to do. There's more bosses after it, more floors after it. There's another version of this floor that comes after it. And then we have an option to go to after that. So we've got some distance. We still have some time left in this run. Now, this is kind of spoiler territory for people who wanted to play this by themselves. So after this point, like after that Mom fight, if you don't want to watch more, don't watch more. Go play the game yourself. There's more stuff after this, and it's cool to finally like figure that stuff out and see all of it and work your way up to that. But if you want to keep watching, keep watching. And that's, you know, genius, that applies to you as well. If you were like, oh, I don't want this spoiled for me, then you don't have to keep watching. But, you know, if you're not, you know, not too offended by it, it's still there. Dude, this is the same run. This hasn't gone any longer than I thought it was going to be. Yeah, it's the same exact run that it was when you left. It's just taken an hour and 5 minutes because I've been stopping a lot and explaining things, and we didn't have any damage, but now we're guppy and shit's going our way, so that's cool. Yeah, so we still have some more bosses after this. Things. Oh, well, there's a left hand. The bosses after this are just kind of crazier than the bosses before it, which is almost like mind-boggling, but it's true. Yeah, this is the same run. It's an hour long, hour and 5 minutes, hour 6 minutes at this point. But yeah, because I've been stopping to explain like everything from the basics to, you know, some of the more, not some advanced stuff, but stuff that most people don't run across immediately. Oh, well, there's another. This is an item that normally gives you flying and a spirit, eternal heart, right? Eternal hearts being those white hearts that, those white hearts that when you take them to the next floor give you a new, like, heart container. So we already have one, right? We picked one up in this floor. You can see it. It's a little white piece on the end of this five red heart bits. When we get another half of that, another half white heart, it'll make one red spirit heart on this floor. Yeah, I mean, it is Isaac 101, but, sorry, I was reading chat. Yeah, so we're gonna pick this up. It'll give us another eternal heart, and it would normally give us flying, but we already have flying because we're guppy. Another eternal heart, which will give us another heart container. And we'll see it. Doop! And now we have another heart container. Yay! We're gonna go in here because we have flying. Damn. So that just teleported us straight to the deal with the angel, which can sometimes happen. So, we're gonna pick up the deal with the angel item. There's a secret in... Oh, fuck! I was like, there's a secret in here, but I wasn't gonna show it off because it's kind of spoilery. We're not gonna pick that up, because that's still spoilery. I mean, do I pick it up? No. There's no point in picking it up. Informative and mildly interesting. Thanks, appreciate it. Mildly interesting is all I aim for, right? So, it's all good. Oh, and we also have the wafer, so no fucking point in not doing that. That poop hurts you when you touch it. I'm not gonna bother with that pill. We're gonna fight the boss. This is Loki. Decently difficult boss, usually, but not right now. We have shielded tears. We're doing a shit ton of damage because we're guppy. We're doing pretty... We're good. We're in a good place right now. Oh, woo, item. Speedball. Or shot speed up. It's Magic 8-Ball. And it drops a tarot card. That tarot card was Wheel of Fortune. The Wheel of Fortune tarot card drops a slot machine or a fortune teller, which you can pay a bunch of money to, and it'll tell you a bunch of fortunes. And sometimes pays out with things that aren't fortunes, like trinkets and tarot cards and spirit hearts and things like that. Sun card, significantly better than the world card. And I'll show you why. So, world card doesn't... Well, we can't really show you why. Maybe a later point. Wow! Alright, so... Do I buy experimental liquid? Might as well buy experimental liquid. All stats up, then shuffle. It's exactly what it sounds like. It shuffles your stats. Gives you an all stats upgrade, then shuffles all of them. Is Taylor playing with me? No, he's not. That is a familiar. There is co-op in this game, but no, he's not. So, we just picked up Dad's Key. I'm going to take Dad's Key, and I said I wasn't going to give you spoilers, but I'm going to give you fucking spoilers. I'm going to show you all the way to the end of the game if I can, if I don't die before then. Yeah, I'm just going to have to put in the description, like, heavy spoilers after... You know, what was that? After floor 8. Because we are... I'm going to show you literally all this game has in terms of boss fights. Not all of it, but a good portion of it. Even the secret final boss that you need to do, like, crazy shit to get to, I'm going to show you that. So, or maybe I won't. Maybe I won't show you that. I'd actually feel a lot better about myself if I didn't show you that. So I'm not going to. As much as I want to. Or maybe I just want you put it on YouTube. I'll stop it before we get to that point. And if you are okay with spoilers on a game that you may or may not play, let me know. Trust me, not all runs end up like this. Not all runs end up with you doing a decent amount of damage and... You know, fucking killing everything with an army of flies. It's not It's not how it always goes. Sometimes you have really shitty runs and things are difficult. And sometimes you have runs that are like 200 times more powerful than this and you can't be touched. And it's crazy and you feel like a god. And it's, you know, insane. Woo! Thank you, Leo. You go in here. Open these up. Spirit heart. Boop. I guess I could be just using Dad's key. Dad's key just opens all doors, right? That's not that crazy. Just opens all doors. It also shows you secret rooms. If you're in the secret room and you use it, it opens the door to the secret room without you having to use a bomb. So that's pretty cool. Health upgrade. Might as well take it. We got a lot of health. Inside the secret room was 3 pennies. Last time we had an item, this time it's 3 pennies. Yeah, it's okay. I just happened to get, like, a pretty good run. I just had to make it last that long. Wasn't looking so good for a while. You know, and I think that some very prolific Isaac players, and I'm going to cite Northern Lion because he's the one that I know the best, has stated that the game, while though, like, ultimately random, there's a lot of random that goes into this, like, random generation in terms of, like, what items you get and if those items are any good and stuff like that. For the most part, it comes down to surviving long enough for the game to actually give you something, right? You know, that takes... And that, I mean, that's what it comes down to, is being able to fundamentally survive long enough that, you know, you get the good item that you need to make the rest of the run not as difficult, you know? And we could just go fight the boss, because I opened that boss door. And it... Normally, doors don't open unless you, that's gonna kill him. Unless you finish a room, but with Dad's key, you can just go straight into it. So, this is, Mom's Heart. This is the boss, the final boss after the first final boss that, you normally end the game with, right? So, you beat Mom enough times, and you can go down to these two floors and fight Mom's Heart. And then when you fight Mom's Heart enough times, you can go to an even further floor, and, we'll go to that. Assuming we beat Mom's Heart, which seems pretty likely, considering Shielded Tears make this bullet hell shit, like, really easy. Right? Ooh. So, one of these takes you to hell, or Sheol, basically. The other one takes you to the cathedral. We're gonna go to the cathedral. Wow, cathedral. See, these rooms are asinine and very difficult if you're not overpowered. I'm overpowered right now. I'm not gonna lie to you. This run is OP. I've got some really good items. I'm being carried. You know, health upgrades out the wazoo. Look at how much health I had. I had, like, one heart at one point. And I was dying consistently. Now we have, like, 2 million hearts. And I'm not too worried about it. Oh, while we're in this long room talk, like, waiting for things, I should talk about the Sun card, which is the tarot card that I have in the bottom right. Sun card is really helpful. It's actually probably the best card in the game for almost every situation. There are some that are better in certain situations, but for the most part, Sun card can't be really beaten. And that's because the Sun card, it shows you the entire map. It fills out everything you can't see on the map, right? So you can go straight to the boss room or... You know, fight things. Yeah, 2 million hearts. You can see it. You count it. Read them and weep. But yeah, the Sun card, right? It shows you the entire map, which is really cool. But it also does damage to everything on the floor, like those black hearts did, and like that death card did. But then it also heals you completely. So if you have like no health and you use it, it'll fill up all your red hearts, which is crazy. Yeah, and I mean, Silas, how many hours have you played? I know that it doesn't matter. It has no bearing on how good you are, bad you are. It's just that, I mean, it does take a while before you can get to this point. The only reason I can be here is because I've played a lot of this game. Woo! Open this up. Spirit heart, money, keys, gold, everything galore. Alright, so we're just gonna go fight the boss. I don't even care. Isaac. Whoa, we're fighting ourselves. That's one of the secret bosses. Not really secret, but this is the boss that comes after the final boss, after the final boss. So, like, this is the third level of final boss. And normally you're like, shit, look at the bullet hell madness that is going on in this boss fight. You know, he's like, oh, whatever, this isn't too bad. And then he starts, like, flying around and shooting beams of light. I actually think Mom's heart is harder than Isaac, normally. But this is, you know, when you first see him, you're like, holy shit, this boss fight. And it's not just this part, it's this upcoming part. You know, cracks, beams of light. If you're not fast enough, those things will get you. But you can also just hide in the corners. And you want to hide in the corner, like, opposite the one that he's on. Not catty corner, but, like, just on the opposite side of the one that he started on. And the lights won't hit you. Got some bullet hell kind of shenanigans going on. And you know how there was that trapdoor and that light on the mom's heart fight? There's another boss equivalent to Isaac, but you have to go down instead of up. And he's slightly harder, right? So 33 hours, hasn't gotten to the cathedral yet, and that's okay. That's, like, that's pretty normal, I would say. That's about average. Alright, so we beat him. Now, this is the area after this. So after you beat Isaac enough times, like, let's say 10 times, you can come here, right? And this is the chest. Wow, the chest. There's this big key door right here. So when I fought that angel, he dropped a piece of a key. In order to go into this door, you need that key. Unless you have Dad's key. In which case, you just use Dad's key, and it opens that door. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. That's why I kind of freaked out when we got that item. Because there was no way I was going to get two more deals with the angel, to kill two more angels, to get the two pieces to go in there. But we didn't need it. And I'm not going to show this necessarily on the video, the YouTube video. We'll come back to it, we'll finish this floor, and then we'll come back and do this fight. On the chest, every chest you open is an item instead of having possibility to get a consumable. It's items. Whoa! So, the quarter gives you 25 cents. We have 99 cents, doesn't make a difference. Cap at 99 cents. Plop, I think? The peeper? My bad. And we have BFF, so it's huge. It bounces around like a peeper's eye does when you get him down to a third health. And that hurts enemies when it touches them. Robo Baby, friends to the end. He follows you around. He shoots lasers out of his face. Cool. Not that great. Not bad. 10 out of 10. Wood Isaac. And then this right here. This is, fuck it, I don't remember. This is Spider Baby, Spider Revenge. So, when I get hit, I think I spawn spiders out of my body, which is cool. And they act the same as flies, but they can't fly, obviously. They just do double damage and go after enemies, and they just walk on the ground and are, in general, kind of cute. So we're going to keep going. We're going to fight all these bosses. Also, at this point in the game, every single room is a boss. This is Dingle. This is the very first boss that I fought on this, this run, right? This is the first floor boss. Now he's just a regular enemy in a regular room. Every floor on the chest is just full of crazy shit. It never ends, never stops. Don't stop. Can't stop. Won't stop. You know. So, we're pretty set. Because we have the... Normally, every time you get hit, you would take a whole heart of damage, but we have the wafer, so we're only taking half a heart. Which is crazy good. But yeah, these are all bosses that you can fight throughout the game. Whoa! And they're dying really fast because we are super strong. Not even, like, that strong, but, like, we're strong enough that I would consider us overpowered. Most runs are not gonna be this strong. I don't know who just texted me. Someone texted me. Could be anybody. Could even be... Donna, Donna, Donna... My mom! Hi, Mom. I love you, too. Alright. We're gonna keep going. I don't know why that poop exploded, but it did. This is kind of ridiculous. Yeah, no, it's a good run. if you were watching earlier, this run looked really shitty. Like, it looked like we were going to lose. I had one heart, you know, fighting things. This is Mr. Mega. Blast damage. It makes our bombs extra big. You know, they do a little bit extra damage. It's cool. Well, we use these butt bombs. So you can see what they do. They confuse enemies for, like, a half a second. Not that good. They do damage to everybody on the floor, or on the room, so that's alright. Got Shield of Tears, so we can block other people's shots with our own shots. The Hourglass slows time in one room. It's shenanigans. It is shenanigans. Shenanigans. Got a room full of spiders. I don't understand this room, but I think this has to do with the fact that, like, tiny spiders are the bane of most people's existence in this game. Like, you just take the worst damage from tiny spiders all the time. This is wildly... This enemy right here is wildly considered the hardest boss of the first floor. So, you know, if that tells you where we're at, they're not that difficult. This is Super Greed. It looks a lot like Greed, but he's got coins for eyes and a big money symbol on his forehead. He's gonna die pretty fast. Drops a bunch of money. Some heart. It's not a one run, Silas. It's not a one run yet. Okay, we killed one of those guys. Remember, we fought some of these guys earlier, and we weren't doing jack shit, and now we're murdering them fairly quickly. I think that's one of the most, like, satisfying parts of this game, too, is when you can finally get down to it, and, you know, all these bosses that were giving you trouble throughout the game are just now, like, easy as shit. Piercing shots. Dude, okay, with Shielded Tears, piercing shots is, like, maybe the most broken thing that's ever existed, and I'll tell you why. Normally, when your tears hit an enemy's tears, it stops your tears, right? Well, for one, they also go through enemies, which is sweet. But this brimstone shots I can't do shit about. But now, because I have piercing shots, my shots are just going to go straight through their shots and still block their shots. So we essentially can't be hit. Okay, Mini Mush is supposed to make us smaller and faster. It didn't make us smaller, but it made us faster. This is Super Lust. Another one of the deadly sins in super form. Range downgrade, not really feeling like taking that. I think we had a half a heart over here or something. A whole heart. This is a one run, I would say. I could always throw, though. You know, that shit happens. You take bad damage. You die. You pick up Scapular. Scapular is actually really good, too. I'm going to stop explaining items at this point, because there's just so many, and they're all working in synergy with each other that it's hard to explain everything that's going on. But once you learn them and figure them out on your own, it all starts to make sense, and you can figure out really cool and interesting ways to abuse the system. Use them for your own good. Make some crazy shit happen. Like, no one knew that key opened that big door that at the end of the game until, like, fairly recently. So we've cleared the entire floor. It's a one run. It's not a one run. It is a one run, man. So we can just sit here. Our tears go through his tears, and our tears also block his tears. So we can just kind of stand here. Like, that's how overpowered this combination of items is. And that's just piercing shots, shielded tears. Woo, we did it. Normally. Okay, this is probably where I'll end the YouTube video. Whoa, sorry YouTube. This is all you get. I would normally grab this chest and the game would be over. So let's pretend that happened and then we'll end the YouTube video. Love you guys, thanks for watching YouTube and my channel, and, you know, hopefully this helped you learn some Isaac stuff.